Hey guys, today I want to talk to you about hormone replacement therapy. Specifically in hormone replacement therapy, testosterone. So testosterone is a male masculine dominant hormone, but males and females both have this hormone. This hormone is really, really important for a lot of different reasons. And that's for cardiovascular health, it's for energy, it's for brain function, and a lot of different things that testosterone helps in the body. It's always good to have good testosterone levels, right? You wanna make sure they're optimal levels, you wanna make sure they're not deficient levels, that's no good, and you don't want them super high either. It's all about a harmonic balance in the body. And having testosterone in an optimal range will get you more optimal results and you'll have a better quality of life. So the main question I get is, John, how do I take testosterone, okay? So there's different forms and methods that you guys can take as far as testosterone. There's options out there. Now, the first option is probably the best option in my opinion. And a lot of different patients also agree with us. And this is usually the protocol with our doctors and medical staff that they do. They usually recommend injections. Now, injections are great because injections, you can change the dose at any point in time. You can have the frequency change in the days that you inject your testosterone replacement. And you can usually keep the levels pretty even keel, okay? Now, there is a needle involved, and sometimes that scares some patients away. They might have a needle phobia. They might have never done this before, and they might just be scared altogether. So that's okay. And now a lot of patients, I would say 7 out of 10 patients, have never done an injection before coming to Tite Medical Center. And now they're doing these injections usually by themselves, in the comfort of their own home or bathroom and doing them by themselves and making sure that everything is good to go there. So it's a really good, simple way, and it's really recommended by Tite Medical Center to do it that way. But there's options like we talked about. Let's talk about those different options. The first option is sublingual. So there is definitely some sublingual troches and sublingual tablets that you can utilize for taking your testosterone replacement therapy. Now, this is a little bit different from an injection because you're using micronized testosterone and it doesn't have an ester. It's not a cypionate, it's not a propionate. So at that point, it's micronized, it's fast acting. And this is something that you would need to take daily, right, to make sure that your levels are going up and everything is good there. Where an injection, you can take it and you're gonna have a frequency of days in between before you take your next injection. So it's not a constant thing you have to do every single day. Now, absorption rate and transportation rate, that's a little bit different too. With the injection, you're gonna get a higher absorbency and a faster transportation rate. With an oral version of sublingual, it's gonna be a lower transportation rate and a lower absorbency. Now, it'll still work. Now you can blood test to make sure this is working and make sure you're dialing in on your dosage too as well. We'll do that here at Tite Medical Center for our patients. But if you're not one of our patients and you maybe want to go this route, that's what you can do to really dial yourself in is the blood test after you take your dose. The next thing is creams, okay? So there's creams out there or gels that you could rub on certain areas and that will absorb through the skin and go into the bloodstream and you will get the benefit of testosterone replacement therapy. Now, this too, like oral, will have to be taken every day for consistent levels, okay? Now, a little bit different here because with a guy, we're hairy in some places. Now, you have to be consistent of where you're going to rub in this cream or gel. Now, women can also do the sublingual. Women can also do the cream and gel and injections sometimes, right? But with this, if you have hairy arms like me, okay, you're rubbing this cream in, the absorbency is not gonna get in as good. It is with an area that doesn't have as much hair, right? So you can rub this or find different places that you can rub this on your body. Now, the next thing with this that you have to think about, if you have a family and kids or dogs or anything like that, is that when you rub this cream or gel on, it's gonna get on your hands. That's one, so make sure you wash your hands afterwards thoroughly so you're not rubbing this on a pet, picking up on a child, or you're rubbing this on your significant other, maybe it's your wife or whatever it may be, so they're not absorbing this cream or gel that you may have on your hands still. So that's the main thing with that. So you gotta make sure that you're keeping everybody safe, you're wiping this on an area. Now let's say if you have kids, you have dogs, you have cats or pets. If you don't, then you're good to go. Just make sure you wash your hands anyway for cleanliness and sanitary purposes, okay? All right, after that, we go into pellets. Now, pellets, you know, they might seem like a good way to do testosterone or hormone replacement therapy because you just go into the doctor or medical provider, they slit you open, right, basically, and they stick these pellets in you. And these pellets have dosages of these different hormones. Now, the difference between injectable, oral, and cream and gels is that you can mess with the dosage at any time or you can stop it at any time. When you go with pellets, all right, and this is, I think, a downfall in my opinion, is that when you go with pellets, you're on that ride no matter what. So if those hormones are maybe too much or maybe too less, you're on that journey and you're gonna keep going up. And usually medical providers or doctors don't blood test you till after these pellets are already done pretty much. So you gotta make sure that these levels are correct. The other downfall, in my opinion, is that when they hit you with these hormones, they have these high doses in there, especially for females. And females, what happens is they spike up really high. And what we've seen here is specifically in testosterone, getting into very high levels, manly levels. So when we're talking about this and you're going to exogenous levels of testosterone, especially for a female, you come into maybe some troubles down the road of negative side effects. So deepening of the voice, hair in these areas or areas that you would not usually grow hair, and clitoral enlargement. So these are things that possibly could not go away. All right, and you might have to live with these negative side effects. So you want to make sure that your levels are good, optimal, but not crazy exogenous and physiological. So at that point, you don't want really crazy high levels. But with guys, the same thing. You take these pellets in and your levels spike. Now it's 3 months, but in between that 3 months, what do you think is happening? You feel really good at the start and then it starts going down. Starts going down. It's because your levels are coming down until you get your next pellet inserted and then it boosts back up. So think about a roller coaster ride, up and down, up and down. So this is not a good thing for the body. You want to be able to go to a consistent level and stay there. That way you're feeling good every day. You're feeling consistent in your mood. You make sure that, you know, everything is working properly and everything is balanced properly. And once you get to the right dosage, whether it's oral or injectable, cream or gel, all you have to do is make sure you sustain that level and consistency with the medications. You blood test with that, and as long as you're consistent with the way that you did it before, you should be getting the exact same results per se, or within the ballpark, within your levels, and consistent in all your results as far as mood, libido, concentration. All these things should be the exact same over and over and over, and as long as you don't change anything. Now, if you change things up or miss days, things can be adjusted and maybe in a negative way, or you might get symptoms. That's totally, you know, in the ballpark of what can happen with you. So just make sure you're being consistent with your regimen and everything should be good. Make sure you guys are picking a good route or form of taking testosterone replacement therapy. Make sure you're going to somebody that's credible, that knows what they're doing and has been doing this for a long period of time. That's what we're here for, Type Medical Center. We'd be happy to help you guys out. You guys can call or text us at 727-389-3220. Check out our website, www.typemedicalcenter.com. YouTube, we have all the videos on our therapies and a lot, lot more. So I'm John from Titan. I appreciate you guys tuning into this video and stay tuned for a lot more content from me and Titan Medical Center. Thanks, guys.